All right, we are recording. So hi, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. I'm really excited to go through this Lead Today Facilitator and Event Staff Training webinar with all of you. Before we get started, I know I just gave some of you the quick and dirty, but a few other people just hopped on. You can speak to me. So if you have any questions, go ahead and just speak to me. If you're not speaking, go ahead and mute. And then we'll save time for questions at the very end as well, so we can talk more through that as well. I'm hoping to keep this to under a half hour, but I have all the time that's needed for all of you all. Everybody, Savannah, I'm on full screen on my end. Are you all seeing small slides?
Hillary, we're seeing like PowerPoint, like when it's not in presentation mode. Can you put it in presentation mode?
He is in presentation mode. Ugh. Okay, hang on.
Yes.
Let's just do my main screen. How about now?
There we go. That's better.
Okay, awesome.
That's it.
All right, we'll go ahead and get started. So, general overview of the program. First and foremost, we have some Kappa friends on the webinar tonight. I'm really excited about this. This is the first opportunity that we've done a lead today where we have had friends of Kappa facilitate for Kappa Kappa Gamma, which I'm really excited about. So our facilitator team that we'll have are Kappa staff members and Kappa volunteers, and then the University of Georgia staff, some individuals from their Greek Life office, same thing with Georgia Tech and Auburn. So we're really excited about that. I think it's going to be a nice mix of people. It's also going to be people that our Kappa volunteers and staff have not worked with before, so we're excited about that. A general overview of the program for those of you who have not facilitated a lead today before or who are a friend of Kappa. Lead today is essentially a one-day full chapter retreat that goes through the five practices of leadership. It's a condensed version of our Kappa Leadership Academy that we have each year for an emerging leader. The unique thing about Lead Today is that only a few chapters nationwide get it each year. And in past years, we've had our chapter team identify who those chapters would be. And this past year, what we did is we had our district teams identify chapters that they thought in their district could benefit from this programming. We sent those chapters an application, and then those chapters chose to apply from there if they were still interested in the program. We had a review committee that looked through all of the applications. We ended up having 15 total applications this year, which is awesome. It was about 50% of the people we reached out to, and two chapters are receiving it, Auburn being one of them. Our Auburn chapter is a little over 300 chapter members. We've never done this program to a chapter that large before, so that's why we've needed so many different hands on deck when it comes to our facilitation team. I talked a little bit about the curriculum, but the curriculum is based on the five practices of leadership, and it will be really important for those of you that have not facilitated our Leadership Academy before to really look through all of the curriculum. There are a number of different activities. If you have facilitated Leadership Academy before, it's definitely stuff that will be very familiar to you. If you haven't, they are not necessarily activities that I would say you probably have come across in other facilitation opportunities. So it's important to really read through and then send me any questions that you may have, or Savannah, and we can talk more about Savannah's role here in a little bit, but Savannah will be our lead facilitator and I can help you. She can help us, especially on that Friday night, really dive into the activities as well. Last piece of general overview. I will send you a couple of things. My goal is to have them out first thing next week. So if you are a friend of Kappa, I do need your address to actually mail it to you. But we will be sending you your facilitator binder. It is spiral bound. It has your event guide, which I sent you all tonight in your email. There will be a few changes to that, not anything drastic, but I'm going to add in some restaurant locations and a few other things. So I will print that and it will be the most up-to-date copy. And then I will also provide the curriculum in there. That should get to you hopefully by the end of next week. And that way you can review the curriculum, highlight, post-it note, whatever works best for you. We'll also be sending you a t-shirt. It's actually a long sleeve t-shirt that you identified what size you would like. I will be sending that to you in that package as well. So if you have any questions or if you need to change your size, let me know by Monday so that I can get you the appropriate size. All right, moving on. So y'all should see a screen that says Friday travel. If you don't, let me know. So everyone will arrive from their respective places on Friday, early morning, afternoon, all different times. If flying, I will coordinate who will be riding with one another. Our Kappa volunteers and staff are the only ones that are flying in. And that will be, I'm going to try and do this off the top of my head, Gail, Kelly, Leah, Liz, Libby, myself, and Savannah. And I believe that is it. If I missed one of you, I'm sorry. I definitely have it all in my stuff. But we will all be flying into the Atlanta airport. And then myself, Lindsay, and Savannah will be driving from the airport. We have rented cars. So we will make sure that that is, everybody is coordinating with travel and we get you to Auburn. Auburn is about 2 hours from the Atlanta airport, and a piece that I want you all to note is that Auburn is actually in Central Standard Time, not Eastern Standard Time. Atlanta is in Eastern Standard Time. So when we're coordinating flights, make sure that you are, especially on your return flight, keeping in mind that you're going to lose an hour going back. Looks like I have a question. Hang on. Okay, can you all hear me? Few people can't hear me.
I can hear you.
Okay.
I can hear you fine too, Hillary.
Okay, awesome. We're just going to keep going. Last piece to that is anybody that is driving or anybody that is coming from the airport, we would like you to be there by 4:30 p.m. At the Hampton Inn. We're staying at a Hampton that's really close to Auburn, so that'll be nice and easy for all of us. If we have any questions about that or if that 4:30 time period doesn't work for some people, just let me know. We will figure it out. But everybody that's flying in, that should be no problem. And Libby and I will actually be arriving really early that morning. I think we land around 8:30 so that we can start doing some logistical things on campus before everybody else arrives. So overnight accommodations, like I said, we're staying at the Hampton Inn at Auburn. Everyone but those that are local will stay in the hotel. I have the rooming assignments. They're listed in the event guide. And any curriculum debriefs or team meetings will be in my room in the hotel. Libby and I are going to be sharing a room, and we actually rented a bigger room so that we had some room to debrief with the curriculum and work with our supplies so that we don't feel super cramped because we're not going to have a communal space in the hotel. But we will, home base will essentially be Libby in my room. And then we will cover your hotel for both Friday and Saturday night. If for some reason you don't want your hotel on Saturday night, please let me know. Again, I know Kappa volunteers, you all will want your hotels for Saturday night. I will want mine as well. But for those that might be driving back to their respective homes Saturday after the event is over, that's completely fine. Just note we probably won't finish until about 10 o'clock that night. So it could end up being a little bit of a longer night for you and a late night to be driving. So Friday night, once we get there, we'll do a semi-work party. We will do a grocery store run. My hope is that I can get that done before all of you arrive. And then we're going to go through all of the supplies that have been sent to the chapter. I will try and go pick those up before we arrive at the hotel. Jordan, I may also talk to you about seeing if I can just send those your way rather than to the chapter location. That way I just can coordinate with you, but you and I can talk after this. We'll do dinner on Friday night. Please, everybody, plan on attending dinner so that we can get to know one another a little bit better, since this is a group of people that do not know one another. And then after dinner, Savannah will lead us through the curriculum on that Friday night. She will walk through each portion of the curriculum, and then we'll be able to ask, do questions and answers for any of you that may need suggestions or that may be confused on a portion of the curriculum. While you all are doing the curriculum overview, Kelly and I will be prepping all supplies. Kelly and I are not facilitators for the weekend. We are event staff. And so we will make sure that everything is where it needs to be, when it needs to be, in the quantity and the amount that needs to be there. like I said before, please plan to read your curriculum before you get there. I know some facilitators, we are very, very skilled and feel like we don't need to read our curriculum before we get there. But if it's new curriculum to you, it's really important you read it. Bring any questions that you may have or reach out to myself or Savannah before so that we can walk through those questions with you. You'll see up on the screen our leadership cards. This is really their program book for Lead Today. Each woman will get her leadership card at the very beginning of Lead Today, and it's double-sided, but each card is numbered. So you can see in the bottom left-hand corner when it says, when the curriculum says handout leadership card number 15, it means the leadership card that has 15 as the page number, not the actual 15th card. In past, we have handed these out individually. That's not necessarily the easiest thing, and it's really hard for facilitators to keep that all straight. So it will come on a binder ring. It's okay to just pass it out to your entire group, the full set of cards, and just tell them not to work ahead until they get further instructions. You're each going to get a facilitator bag, and program staff, so Kelly and I, will share a bag. This has all of the items that you're going to need throughout the weekend in the bag. Everything should be counted out and ready for you, but it's important that you also look in your bag and make sure that you have everything too. Leadership cards will be provided to your group, so I will give those to you, and Kelly will give those to you likely on Friday night when we're sorting and separating out supplies. The red, yellow, green circles are for the red, yellow, and green values continuum activity. Each participant will get one of each color. As you're reading through your curriculum, you will recognize what that values continuum activity is. You'll also, if you don't want to hand out red, green, or yellow circles, there will be three signs that will be printed out, one red, one green, and one yellow, that you'll be able to hang up in your room so that if you don't want each person, essentially it's an activity where you are saying, you're asking a question and you're telling them, is it okay? Raise green. Are you unsure? Raise yellow. Is it not okay? Raise red. If you don't want to do the raising thing, you can have them move to a different section in the room. You'll have both options for that activity. I know that sometimes is confusing. Why do I have the signs and the colored circles? It's your choice to do whatever you'd prefer with either of those. Please don't bring anything to decorate your rooms. We will provide leadership quotes for you from Leadership Academy, and we will also give you the putty to hang them up. We're really not going to have a lot of time on Saturday morning to do anything other than hanging these items and making sure that everything's good to go in your room. And then participants should have brought a writing utensil, but if they didn't, we'll make sure that they have writing utensils. We did ask that they do that. So if there are any questions about that, I'm happy to help. And you will have the pens that they need. But please ask them to make sure, well, like just ask them to use their own to begin with. So who is in your group? First and foremost, you'll have about 16 to 18 women. It could be more, it could be less. I highly doubt it will be more than 18, knowing that we have I think it's 13 facilitators or 14 facilitators and a 300-person chapter. Not everybody will be attending. I'm sure there are many people that are unable to attend, but the chapter is expected to have an 80% attendance rate at this program. You should not know the participants in your group. If you work on campus and are acquainted with some, that's totally fine. I don't want you to have somebody in your group that you have directly advised or that has been in another small group or that you have passed somehow that you know well. I will send you your group assignments before we arrive. If you know somebody, let me know and we will switch that around. The chapter at Auburn really knows very little about Lead Today. They will have a pre-call, chapter council will have a pre-call with myself and Savannah before we arrive to tell them a little bit more about the program. And Jordan was also asked to go and talk with the chapter more about what Lead Today is. So Jordan and I will be talking tomorrow so that she can relay some information to the chapter. But other than that, they really just know that they are getting this awesome opportunity. Not every Kappa chapter gets it, and it's going to help develop some leadership skills within their chapter. So your small group space is going to be classroom style. The location is Louder Hall. There are various rooms, and those are within your event guide. Like I said earlier, please don't bring any additional items to decorate your space. You will have the leadership quotes. That's it. You will only be able to set up from 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. in the morning, so we do not have a ton of time to play around with this. I would also tell us to dress in layers. It may be very warm outside. It may be cold. I don't really know. I'm hoping it's going to be warm. But the buildings also could be cold ourselves. So bring a sweatshirt and then layer yourself with a sweatshirt and a t-shirt or whatever it may be. You'll notice, and I'll talk about this in a little bit, throughout the curriculum, you have the ability to choose your own path and or determine like where you want to do your journey hike. And that can be outside or that can be inside, but just be prepared for whatever location you choose to pick for that. So that leads me to attire. Although we'll be indoors for most of the day, and like I talked about this a little bit just a couple minutes ago, you will have the option to take your group outside, presuming that the weather is nice, for some activities. Some of the activities you'll notice in your curriculum are stump jump, traffic jam, helium sticks, and the values journey. All four of those, you can take your group outside if you'd prefer. It'll be up to you to determine whether or not you would like to do that. So please bring a water bottle as well. And then also like a sweatshirt and a sweater, but the water bottle, we will not be providing you per se. And I'm sure that you will be able to find water fountains in there, but if you're outside, back inside, etc., you may want to make sure that you have a water bottle and then various clothing. We've asked the participants to make sure that they're casual. Our facilitators, you'll wear your blue Lead Today shirt. Event staff will do the same. And then I covered the rest of everything else in this slide. So curriculum highlights. Because we're unfamiliar with the space and have limited event staff, we also are unsure as to whether or not the weather is going to cooperate with us. We won't be prescribing your values journey hike for you. For those of you that have facilitated Leadership Academy, this is a change. So for those of you that have never facilitated Leadership Academy, we won't be prescribing the values journey for you. This one's on your own. The expectation is that you see the space on Saturday morning at 8 o'clock and you determine what path you'd like to take. We're not going to be able to get into the space earlier than 8 o'clock. We're also not going to get into it on Friday night. So just make sure that you plan to hit the ground running right at 8 o'clock when you get in. Your options are to utilize some small group spaces that you will have, utilizing the large group space, which is where Kelly and I will essentially be home based at, utilizing community spaces, which can be your hallways or maybe any larger areas in the building that there may be available, and then any outdoor space. But you'll decide where your stops are going to be. That one's completely on you. Something you'll notice about the curriculum and the event guide is that your activities are not scheduled out for you. So for example, you are told that you have 55 minutes for the vision poster. However, you have between 3:15 and 4:50 for inspiring a shared vision, where you have to do the toxic swamp or Zoom and your vision poster. So in that situation, you have what is that? An hour and 35 minutes. However, you know that you're going to need 55 of those minutes for vision posters. So you're responsible for managing your group's time in order to get everything done. I would just advise writing that all into your curriculum so that it matches with your event guide and the clock. So if you know you've got to do your vision poster, it's going to take us 55 minutes. From 3 to 4:10, we're going to work on our vision posters. From 4:10 to 4:50, we have time to do Toxic Swamp or Zoom. Again, you will just need to work through that yourself. After each group presents their vision poster, they're only going to get 1 minute per group. One facilitator will do the module summary that will lead into enabling others to act. I believe that is you, Gail, in the event guide, but I will double check. And then please make sure that you have reviewed the curriculum before you arrive. I can't say that enough. It's in my notes everywhere. So make sure that you've done that, as well as the event guide, because the event guide will really keep us on track. The curriculum is going to tell you what to say and when to say it. So if you find yourself needing some help, you have several options. write it down so that we can make sure it doesn't happen again. If there's a moment where you're like, oh shoot, I don't know this, or this wasn't prepared for me, or I could have been more prepared in them because they could have told me X, Y, and Z, write that down. If you're really like, okay, I can't do this. I don't know what's going on. I'm confused. I don't have supplies, whatever it may be. You can ask myself, Kelly, for supplies, or you can ask Savannah for curriculum. And then lastly, improvise. Sometimes we have no idea if something's going to be thrown our way that we weren't expecting. And just like Leadership Academy, the participants really have absolutely no expectation as to what they're going to experience. So if you need to adjust something for time or sensitivity or whatever it may be, please do so. And if you need more of something, try to get by in the moment. Or you can text me and Kelly and we will come get it to you. And if you can't get by, just let us know right away and we'll get that taken care of. And we'll also make the change so that it doesn't happen on the next lead today. So for meals, meals for the participants, they will get breakfast. I'm going to do bagels, yogurt, fruit, juice boxes, that kind of a thing. That will be served at the registration table and they're going to eat in the large group space. And then all of the facilitators will eat before we arrive. If you are planning on staying at home, please eat before you come. If you are staying at the hotel, we will do breakfast at the hotel. Lunch for that afternoon is going to be pizza. It's really hard to feed a group of 300 affordably and quickly. So we're going to do pizza. It's going to be in the same space that we had the breakfast that morning. And then we'll also do a snack afterwards. You all, we will cover your dinner on Friday and Saturday evening. Anybody that needs meals on Sunday as you're traveling, all of that kind of stuff, we will, of course, cover. So we can talk through any questions that you may have with that. But our biggest things will be that we'll eat breakfast at the Hampton. Lunch on Saturday will be taken care of, and Friday and Saturday dinner will go out somewhere. The snack that you get, Kelly and I will make sure is delivered to your room so that you don't have to worry about that piece either. We talked about this a little bit before, but Saturday morning, we only have from 8 until 9:15 to organize your small group space. It says 9:15 on here, but really registration is closing at 9:15 and we're starting at that point. So it's really going to be best for you to be finished at 9. You need to map out where you think you're going to do the values journey, and you're going to need to get oriented with the walk from small group space to large group space. I have no idea how big this building is, so it may take you 2-3 minutes to get from your small group space, or it may be right next door to the large group space. Just know how much time you're going to need because we need to stick to that strict event guide. If anybody has extra hands, I'm sure Kelly and I would not turn down help with the registration table. We will be checking everybody in, getting them a name tag and making sure that they get breakfast. But, again, that'll be something that if you have extra hands and your room is done, please come help us. We'll do icebreakers as a large group right at 9:15. And then we'll also make sure that we're greeting participants when they come in. It's really nice for them to get to know who you are. There are many of you that they have heard of your names or have been on calls or gotten emails from you, but they don't know who you are. So it's an opportunity for you to really get to meet these women as well. So Saturday night, once the actual event is done, we are going to debrief. Well, first off, we're going to go to dinner. I guess this is kind of backwards. We're going to go to dinner, and then we're going to debrief the curriculum, and we're going to prep for a goal-setting session with Chapter Council. This is new this year. It's something that after we did our last lead today at Virginia Tech, we felt like we needed to add. It's an opportunity for the large group facilitator to sit down with Chapter Council on that Sunday morning and go through all of the goal setting, things that they talked about as a large group and small group the day before and lead today. We want to make sure that they have a nice plan and a good mapped out. It all just needs to be mapped out, and they need to make sure that they understand what their goals are as a chapter so that they can continue to move the needle forward towards positive change and towards positive leadership within this chapter. It'll be important to really talk about like what were some of the challenges throughout the day and what were some of the wins throughout the day. These are going to be important for Savannah to know so that she can be prepared to go into that meeting the next morning. And then this will also be opportunities for you to provide suggestions to us, like didn't like this part of the curriculum, did like this part of the curriculum, didn't like this, the way that this worked out, or did like the way that this worked out. This is an opportunity for us to have an open forum and share and make sure that we are taken care of and updating this program as it needs to be. I will say we are in the process of redesigning our Leadership Academy program, and in doing that, Lead Today will also be redesigned. So suggestions and constructive criticism moving forward is going to be really helpful. I would ask that it is just that, constructive criticism. So if we are going to have some negatives, give some ideas as to how we can improve the experience and not just be negative about it. Last thing, and you'll see it here on the screen, there's a lot and it's very little, but these are all of the people that will be on our team that weekend. My phone number is on here. Everybody take a minute to jot it down. If you have an issue with your flights, if you have an issue with somebody being sick, if there's anything that you need and it's the day of, or we're traveling or whatever it may be, this is the best way to reach me. So 740-398-2544 is my cell. Libby and I think are leaving super early that morning, but we should be in Atlanta by 8:49 a.m. So 8:50, we should be landed. And then I'll be available the rest of the day for all of you if it's needed. So Taylor, Merritt, Amanda, Alton, Jameson, and Tori are all friends of Kappa. And then myself and Kelly are our event staff. Libby, Leah, Jordan, Savannah, Gail, Liz, and Lindsay are all going to be serving as facilitators as part of either HQ staff or volunteers. You can see your airline arrival and your time as well as your departure time. This is also in the event guide. Like I said earlier, if you are local, you will drive yourself. If you are flying, I will assign you a car to get back to get from the airport to the Hampton and then from the Hampton back to the airport. On the way here, the people that would be able to drive you are really going to truly be Lindsay and Savannah. On the way back, Savannah will be staying. So the people that will be driving will be myself and Lindsay. Lindsay and Savannah, you will have smaller, it's a full-size four-door sedan. Libby and I will be carrying, we're going to have a larger SUV to make sure we get all of the supplies, luggage, and then get everybody back on Sunday morning because we're going to be down a vehicle. So that is truly the travel. Sums it up for the most part. Do you all have any immediate questions that I haven't answered? You don't have to put them in the question box. Just unmute yourself and ask. I take this as good things.
You covered it, Hillary.
Okay, thanks, Leah.
Great job.
Thanks, guys. Okay, if we have any other questions, you all know how to get a hold of me. I'm sorry that we had to reschedule on Monday. I was so not anticipating being gone. I was not anticipating still driving at that point. We thought it was going to take us about 7 hours to get there, and it took us almost 9.5. So I appreciate your flexibility. If you all have any other questions, please let me know. I will be out of the office on Friday. I'm actually headed to a Lead Today in Wyoming, but I will be back all next week. I will get everything out to you. And if you have any other immediate questions, comments, or concerns while I'm gone, just shoot me an email or send me a text with that cell phone number that I gave you. All right, everybody, have a great night. And I'm looking forward to seeing you all in just a few weeks. Bye, everybody.
Thanks, Hillary. Bye, everyone.
Bye.